this shot. That's wide of the net. Larmer from Roenick and Marchment at 15:35. 4-0 Chicago. Larmer again for Vincelette. Couldn't get the pass by Dave Ellett. Now you watch the Hawks try and set up JR. Jeremy Roenick for his third. And Larmer will get a few passes, I'm sure, too. Marchment took a run at Wendell Clark. Clark hacked at him. Now he wants him. And Steve Smith is wrestling with Clark. This will draw everyone into this fray. Stu Crimson's on the ice, trying to get at Clark from behind. Marchment's tied up at center by Bob Halkidis. Those two have been at each other for this game and all of the last one.
Ugly part when players are all tangled up, are on the ice, and Grimson's going to get himself into big trouble.
You bet he's going to be in big trouble if he starts manhandling Merrowelli. Very close to the abusive officials category. In fact, I think in it.
And he's not finished yet. He's not thinking clearly.
At the bottom of this pile is Wendell Clark. That's who Crimson wants. Deblois taking a shot from Steve Smith. Smith is cut. Clark is tied up by Ray Scampanello and Steve Larmer. I don't know how Steve got that cut, but he obviously dove into the pile when everyone went at each other.
That's what I say. When you see all the players tangled up as they were, skates are flying around, sticks rustling on the ice. You have to be at the bottom of the pile. You're in trouble.
Wendell Clark is off the ice. They've been able to get him down into the dressing room, and now they got to get Steve Smith and Stu Crimson off the ice, and they should be able to handle the rest of this. Smith is now going. Nope. They don't want to take Crimson off right now because they'll have to take him by the other players.
Keenan's trying to pull Crimson right to the bench, but he's upset at Merrowelli.
And Clark have been at each other most of the night, and this time Marchment went at Clark with his stick, and Marchment has had a broken cheekbone, so he's wearing the full face visor. There's Crimson trying to get loose, and now he's gone crazy.
He's right out of it. Keenan was doing everything he could to hold on to him. Look at him.
This is a man gone mad.
Keenan was trying to hang on to him. Almost ripped the shirt off of him.
These are the things that the NHL has to legislate against. These are the incidents they have to stop by huge, huge penalties. They'd almost had this cleared up. Dan Marinelli finally let Grimson go because he thought the coach was looking after Grimson. He manhandled Marinelli. He's kept this going. They finally got him in the penalty box. He's likely going to get the book thrown at him for this.
They didn't even want a chance trying to push Grimson all the way down to the end of the rink to throw him out of the game. But he's still a dangerous man the way that he's revved up right now, even in the penalty box. Grimson's gone so mad, I wouldn't even want to be the Chicago timekeepers.
There's been a long, hard look by league governors and general managers in recent weeks over the increase in fighting, at the increase in fighting in the National Hockey League this season. And there'll be more calls for it after an ugly incident like this, when there's been some very pretty goals scored tonight. A great night for Roenick and Larmer. You know what people across America will see on the television highlights from this game.
Yeah, that's the unfortunate part, because Grant Fuhr put on a great show, made some fabulous saves. Probably no prettier goal has been seen in this game than Jeremy Roenick's outstanding breakaway effort.
Stu Grimson's had, what, two or three shifts, and he'll get all the airtime in the highlight pack. Take a while to sort out the paperwork. Will have to score in the game is 4-0 for the Blackhawks. 3:46 is left in the third period. The paperwork is being done at the timekeeper's bench. Marchment and Clark, combatants throughout the evening, got it started. Marchment more than Clark starting this incident. Watch this. He only has eyes for Wendell.
Marmer was trying to cover up on the puck to get a whistle.
Marchment took a run at him. Clark gave him a chop, and then all this started.
This is how it started initially, when Larmer had a one-on-one with Wendell Clark and was trying to cover up on that puck. Ooh, Marchment really did give Clark quite a belt right in the face.
Then Clark gave him a chop, and away they went. Simpson away. He wanted to get at Clark. Marinelli got a hold of him, let the linesman go after the rest of the pileup, and he did a nice job of keeping Grimson away. He got manhandled over by the penalty bench. Marinelli stayed right with him until it seemed that Mike Keenan had control of Grimson, and he left him standing there, and then he went crazy. And that was scary.
He obviously didn't want players.
Is that abuse of officials?
I guess.
Twice during this altercation, he manhandled a referee and then a linesman. That was a frightening sight.